there was this makeup tutorial that I did a long, long time ago, and that was a Canada-inspired makeup tutorial, but a lot of people told me that it was really difficult to see because there was a point where I had to basically switch cameras. So instead of having a somewhat barely decent camera, I switched it to my really crappy webcam. So literally you couldn't see what was there. So today I'm gonna do that. Now I apologize for this beginning because my face is like bland and there's like nothing there. But finally I got a memory card that works with my camera and will record more than 10 seconds. So here we go. I'm gonna go and redo that tutorial. So hopefully you guys enjoy it. I know it's ridiculously overdue. I think that was like 3 to 4 years ago. But yes, I hope you guys enjoy it. And here we go. All right, let's begin. So I already have all of my foundation and concealers and all that stuff's on. And then here I'm just applying a very light peach color. Like, it's peachy enough to be seen. And then I'm going to apply that darker orangey color on the crease on the outside corners of my eyes. And that's mainly because it reminds me of maple syrup. And Canada likes maple syrup. Now, since this is more of an cosplay/inspired look, I didn't really do much with my face because even the character doesn't look too ridiculously overly makeup. Does that make sense? Like, I'm probably making no sense, but the character looked pretty natural. Though in the end, I don't think I looked very natural anyway, but whatever. And then also just put eyeliner. First I use the powder because I'm out of order sometimes. And then just kind of drag that underneath my eyes just to show, well, just to get like a bigger eye sort of effect. And then I'm at this point I'm just concealing the rest of my face just to get rid of the little dust drops. And then at this point I am probably going to do my eyebrows. Okay. Honestly, I wasn't sure because it's been a while since I've recorded this. I'm actually doing this voiceover weeks, well, months afterwards. Like, this video should have been up since like December. Whoops. So yeah. Anyway, at this point I'm just contouring. You guys can contour however you like. Just kind of keep it natural because Canada is a natural beauty. And I mean the Nutella character version, not the, well, I mean, obviously the nation is also a natural beauty. You guys are awesome. Anyway, at this point, I'm just putting on like a lip balm and then a sort of like lip tint. But I guess it didn't really tint my lips, it just ended up making them look paler. So I honestly would suggest a darker color on the lips. Well, not darker, just, you know, more pink. No, like, don't peel out your lips. Especially if, I guess, for cosplay, because, yeah. It's a very common thing to pale out the lips if you're cosplaying a male character, but here we're doing Natalia, so. Anyway, at this point, I just kind of, like, grabbed stuff from my closet. I think I explained that later, so I'm sorry if this is kind of repetitive. Anyway, this is pretty much the end of the voiceover. So I will get back. I will let you get back with past me.
So that's pretty much it for this look. I don't normally cosplay Canada. So I had to grab a lot of things from my closet. Like, obviously I don't believe Natalia Canada wears like a sweater like this. Or I don't know, this is just one of my Lolita wigs. But I guess it works. But that was just a quick little tutorial. Obviously, Nutella Canada has like blue eyes, but I couldn't find those contact lenses today, and I am like ridiculously blind for that. But so that's that. Anyway, thank you for watching. If you guys would like to suggest a character on that you'd like to see for me to do a makeup tutorial slash test type of thing, go ahead and leave it in the comments, and go ahead and like and subscribe to see my other videos. I'm gonna really try and upload more since I kind of have more time now. So we'll see how well that works. Anyway, hope you guys have a great day and thank you for watching. Bye.